Hi there. Welcome to the first video installment of Virtual Studios brought to you by the Taft Museum of Art and Urban Sketchers Cincinnati. My name is Robin Carnes and I am a local watercolor artist and one of four admins for the official Cincinnati chapter of Urban Sketchers, along with Christina Wald, Jeb Brack, Amy Bogard, and you'll get to meet them throughout this video series as well. So be sure to keep watching. If you're not familiar with Urban Sketchers, it's a global nonprofit organization dedicated to sketching on location, documenting the world one sketch at a time. We're very lucky to have a chapter here in Cincinnati. There are chapters all over the world. Our group normally meets once a month to sketch outdoors on location, different places throughout the city. But obviously with the recent events, the Taft had this great idea to contact us and get us involved so that we can bring the sketching to you. So in case you'd like to learn a little bit more about Urban Sketchers or Urban Sketchers Cincinnati, you can find our pages on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter by searching Urban Sketchers or Urban Sketchers Cincinnati. And then you can also find me on Instagram as at REWERS, that's REWERS. And on Facebook is REWERS Designs. In case you have questions about the topic that I'm going to discuss today or just questions in general of my materials, and also to see the finished sketch that I come up with the topic today. So the most important thing that you need to know about Urban Sketchers is that it doesn't require you to be a seasoned artist. It's really aimed at anyone who just has the want to draw or to sketch. It doesn't matter if you have been drawing your entire life or you've just bought a sketchbook yesterday. There's no judgment, there's no experience necessary, which is the best part of it. And I encourage you to join us at one of our outings when life gets back to normal. So I'm gonna show you some supplies real quick. So I use three different sketchbooks when I go sketching. I like the smaller size ones and a couple different brands. This is a Moleskine. This is a handbook mixed media, and this is a handbook watercolor. So it just kind of depends on what I'm drawing. I like to change it up a little bit. Let's see here. Then the next thing I have are my palettes. So here's one of my bigger ones here. It opens up into a lot of different pans in here. I've had this one for a while. It's quite dirty, but it gets the job done. My smaller one, which I love, is this little tiny Whiskey Painter's palette. This is great for on-the-go sketching. It has removable pans. It's great for, it's pocket size. It's just great for throwing in your purse or your bag or something like that. I use a couple different brushes as well. This is a water brush. You can see there's water in there already. This is great if you don't want to carry water with you. I also sometimes use regular paint brushes, and then carry a little mason jar full of water. It's, you know, tight enough. It doesn't leak, which is great. The pens I use a mechanical pencil to get my sketch in first. I use Micron pens. These are waterproof, which is great because I usually do my inking first and then I paint. I use a size 01 and a size 08. I sometimes use a rubber masking fluid pen, which is great to keep the natural color of your paper free of paint. You know, that way you can just take this off later and you've got a nice bright spot. And then for the times that I forget to do that, I like to use a little jelly roll pen. This is a white opaque pen, for great for highlights, things like that. A couple other things, a couple of different erasers, a kneaded eraser and a regular gum eraser, great to have, and also binder clips. These are nice to keep your pages from flapping in the wind, or also the big ones are great for holding your palette on your sketchbook too if you don't have anywhere to sit. So that being said, we're gonna get into our topic. We're actually gonna talk about composition today. We're gonna sketch from some of the works in the collections that the Taft has currently. So the one that I'm going to be looking at is the Dark Harbor Fisherman from N.C. Wyeth. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about composition, and I'm actually going to show you a little bit about how I sketch in and get my lines down on my paper when starting a new sketch. Okay, so we're going to just briefly talk about composition here. And seeing in shapes is the best way to approach any sketch. Geometric shapes
is a great foundation. So when you are looking at certain parts of this image here, the gentleman's hat in the photo, I start with circles because that's basically what it is. You can kind of see some of my lines that I've kept here. That's how you start with these circles. The most important thing I've learned is when you're starting to draw something, you really want to draw with your arm and your shoulder and not your wrist and your hand. And what that means is this is drawing with your wrist and your hand, is keeping your hand still and just moving your arm still, I'm sorry, and just moving your wrist. You're not getting a full range of motion. When you draw with your arm and your shoulder, you really can get more of a range of motion with your sketches. So, for example, with this portion of the photo, I'll just start with the box here. And to get things in the right spot, you can always do a grid system or just a peg system here. You can use a ruler to be a little bit more exact. But when you look at a picture and you want to draw it, the boat here, and this line right here is roughly halfway of this edge of the line. So you want to make sure that you're placing your objects in the right spot, and you want to kind of look at things and the objects in terms of where they are in relation to the other objects, if that makes any sense. So the boat here comes over more than half of this side of the picture. And so you want to make sure that the point of that boat is coming all the way over there. Now, the other two boats that are in the images provided here, they kind of come out at an angle like this. This second boat is a little bit further back, right here. Kind of lines up right there. And then the other boat comes out here. You can always erase your pencil lines. You don't have to worry about all these things. Drawing through is a huge help. That way you're not just drawing, here's this shape, here's this shape, and here's this shape. You want to be loose with your lines. Again, draw with your arm and your shoulder versus just your hand and your wrist. So the other thing I wanted to just mention real quick was that, composition is great, but you don't always have to think about composition in terms of the actual photo reference that you're painting from. You can actually think of composition in terms of your sketchbook pages. So if you have a rectangular sketchbook page or a square or something like that, think about how this painting or a section of this painting would relate in terms of the composition of your page. So I personally like this gentleman at the yellow apron. So I've really kind of focused on him versus the entire image. And so I just started with circles up here to do his hat. It's, kind of start with this outline, and then you can fine-tune it by coming back and doing some of these other lines. And you can see how messy my sketches are. It doesn't need to be perfect. And again, that's what erasers are for. And see where his shoulder lies, like that. So you can kind of see that drawing through is a great way to start your sketches. That way you can see where you're going, where you've been, and you won't make as many mistakes, in my opinion, if you learn to start drawing like that.
Okay, so don't forget to post your finished sketches on social media this week. Use the hashtag Taft Museum Discovered. You can also use the hashtags USK Cincinnati and USK at Home so we can see your awesome work. And we'll see you next Monday for the second installment of Virtual Studios. Thanks for joining in.